Another video. So this is Wrath of the Norsemen, the Baltic, but it's a sub-mod for the mod. So Wrath of the Norsemen, the Baltic was a beta release from 2011, developed between, I believe, 2007 and 2011. So version 1.5 released in 2011 by the original team. It was a group of modders over at the Lore Center who made the first beta, version 1.5. And then in 2016, I decided to continue it. There were also a submod made named Regnum Francorum that released in February 2018, based on my release of, I believe, December 2017. Okay, so this mod is set in the Viking Age, and I've recently released a new version of the main release and a new submod. And this submod, named Factions United, is based on the original main release and the Regnum Francorum submod from 2018. So the modder Appin did a submod named Regnum Francorum, which focused on the East Francia faction, the Germans. While this submod, Factions United, has a different focus, but it's based on the main version of the mod and that other submod. Okay, so we will go to multiplayer, hot seat campaign, and check the factions. We will have managed all cities. Use passwords will be off. We have no battle time limit. We can have difficulty in both battle and on the campaign map on medium difficulty. Because anything higher than medium will just give the enemy benefits in battle, and on the map I believe it's more difficult to gain allies and such. But anyway, so there are a bunch of factions. I believe they are 22, I might be wrong. Okay, so we have Prussia. So in the Factions United submod, unlike in the main mod, they start with all their territories. So on this map they only have the original starting positions, because I'm no 2D guy, I can't change the starting locations on the minimap. You need to have skills in art and such to do that, and I don't have that, so that's why it looks the same as in the main mod on the map here. In the main mod you would start in this small area, but in this mod, Factions United, I've united all the rebel areas of a certain faction into one giant faction, so Prussia will probably have a bigger area here. Then we have Morafylke, one of the Norse factions. There are four Norwegian Viking factions, or Norse factions. This is one of them, one of the smaller. On this map they have like two areas or something, but they have a few more when we start the game. Take a look at that when we start it up. So this game, by the way, has custom music too. But I've disabled the custom music for this video because YouTube usually block the video after a while, and then no one can watch it because of the copyrighted music. So by reverting the music to vanilla music, I won't have the video copyright struck. I believe my preview video of my changes from 2018 in February, I did release an update in February 2018, and I did a video for that version of the game, of the mod, and that video was watchable for a long time, and then all of a sudden it got copyright struck and blocked in many countries, and I had to mute all the sound. That's not good when I'm speaking, because if I mute the music I also mute my voice and stuff. So I needed to use the vanilla songs from Medieval Total War Kingdoms in order to prevent YouTube from blocking the video in certain countries. But there are custom music in this mod, and if you want it enabled, I believe you just go to the... I mean, the current release, I believe, have the custom music already at start when you download the mod. And then you can download the vanilla music as a package if you want it instead. For example, if you want to play a Let's Play on YouTube, it's better to use the vanilla music, so it won't get copyright struck and blocked. But I plan on probably uploading a new version of the mod where I have the vanilla music from the start, and then you can just go to the WotN RF data sounds folder and switch out the music with files. I believe there will be a folder inside of the sounds folder where that says custom music or something. Custom WotN music. WotN is short for Wrath of the Norsemen, the name of the mod. Okay, so there will be a folder that there named custom WotN music or something, and then you just switch out the music if you want the custom music. Of course, the game is much more epic with the custom music, but unfortunately, if it gets copyright struck on YouTube, it's not very good to have it playing and doing videos. Okay, so we are using vanilla music now, but the mod has custom music too. Okay, and Morafylk is one of the Norse factions. The Norse is short for all the Viking factions. They are all Norse, but especially the Norwegians are called Norse, while the Danes would rather be called Danes. And then the Swedes, and the Gutes, and the Geats are just named. Yeah, you can say just Swedes, Gutes, and Geats there. So we have Danes, and we have the Norse, which is the Norwegians, but one could also call all the Viking factions the Norse. Okay, so Morafylk is one of the smaller Norse factions. Then we have the Frankish Empire, starting down here. It's the East Frankish Empire, or East Francia. So it's the German part of the Frankish Empire. Then we have the Kersey. Coronians, starting here. We have the Rigaland faction, another small Norse faction, Norwegians. We have Gotland, the Geats. So they later became part of the nation known as Sweden, but here they are independent, an independent tribe. Sweden is using their colors, by the way. But I believe that if I'm not wrong, I believe Gotland managed to conquer Svitjod, but in order to convince the Swedes to accept the alliance or union, they decided to use the colors of Gotland, actually. But the name of the or it may be the opposite, that the Swedes conquered Gotland. In exchange for them willingly accepting that, they had their colors. Something like that. Sweden is using the colors of Gotland, but the name of Svitjod. So, Sverige in Swedish is like our version of, like, I believe in Swedish, Svealand. Or Svealand is the name of the country of Sweden, but the common language is such that the way we say the country is Sverige. So, but it means Svealand or Svealand. So it's because of the way the language works that Sweden is spoken in a different way than it's originally translated in written language. Of course, the current name in Swedish in written language is more similar to how it's spoken. it's supposed to be named Svealand, but the way we speak it ended up Sverige instead. So land at the end is how it originally was intended to be spoken. Okay, so Gotland is independent in this game. The Geats, or Götar in Swedish. Then we have Vestfold, another Norse faction. They are actually huge in this submod because they have all their areas. Vestfold, that's the one Norse faction that united all of Norway. So they will form the Kingdom of Norway. They can't do that in this mod. There are four different Norse factions and they can't unite Norway. Vestfold is the one that is destined to unite the tribes into one single country known as the Kingdom of Norway. But here they are known as Vestfold. the Jarldom of Vestfold. Okay, we have Kvenland. That's like the mix between Sami and Finns of this mod. So the Sami faction pretty much, but it also has Finnish people. Okay, and they start over here. In this submod they have an area that is bigger than on this picture, of course. We have Gardariki or Godarike, Swedish, which is like the Russians or the Rus. Gardariki Rus is also their name. Okay, so they are the Rus people, the Russians. Okay, we have Helgoland, the fort, Norse faction, Norwegian Norse faction. They are pretty big. And then we have Häme, Finnish faction. They control almost all of Finland in this submod. We have Jutland. They still only have one area, Visby or Visbyr. I believe Visby in Swedish, Visbyr in Old Norse and in this mod. And they still have only one area on the Isle of Jutland. They are their own faction. Later they joined with Sweden. They had a common enemy in Denmark. Okay, but in this game they are still independent, and unlike the others, they do not get any new areas in this submod. So they are the weakest faction in the game, but they are separated from others because they are an Isle in the sea. So they are kind of protected from most factions, but I believe that Gotland and Svitjod might actually invade them, maybe even Denmark. It's happened when I have used them to watch the AI play, then Denmark, Gotland or Svitjod have sometimes landed troops there and taken Visbyr, and then I have lost. So it's possible they can land here, but it's usually Denmark, Gotland or Svitjod that will invade Jutland. Okay, we have Denmark, the strongest faction in the game, the Danes, another Norse faction. They are the strongest one. In this mod they are not led by Ragnar Lothbrok, because he only got control over Denmark or Denmark in this game. In a later time period. This game mod started in 785 AD. It's before Ragnar became their king. Okay, so they have a different leader than Ragnar here, but they are the strongest faction in the game. Strongest Viking faction and the strongest overall faction. Of course the Franks would have been the strongest if their entire country was on the map, but they are not. Only a small portion of the Frankish Empire is on the map. That's why they aren't the strongest. Okay, we have Svitjod. The Swedes. They are led by Ragnar Lothbrok here, and in this submod we have access to a unique Lagertha model too, both on the map and in battle. So Lagertha, Shield Maiden and Ragnar Lothbrok is a part of this faction. Okay, Svitjod, the Swedes. So Gotland and the Geats, they are like the Geats in the future, they will be together with the Swedes will form Sweden, but in this mod they are three separate tribes, and this is the main Swedish tribe, but I believe the colors of the future country of Sweden would be Gotland's colors and not Svitjod's. Okay, and this faction is the one you want to play if you want to be Ragnar Lothbrok in this mod or Lagertha. Okay, and then we have the Ubotrites. They are like Visten Slaws, I believe, could be wrong. They are about to be conquered by the Franks actually and become their vassal. They are the second weakest faction in the game. They have three areas at the start, surrounded by enemies, including the most powerful Danish faction, the most areas and armies and best economy. Of course, Francia is also very strong. They have only a few areas. They are pretty broke, but they have the best troops. They have heavy cavalry and such. And then they have the East Slavic country of Vendland here, actually. Vendland. So they are surrounded by enemies, so this will be a difficult faction to play as. Even more difficult, I believe, than Jutland, because Jutland is protected by the sea. while Ubotrites, they are surrounded by enemies on land. So it will be difficult to place them. We have Vanland, another East Slavic faction. But unlike the others, they stretch a pretty vast area here. They are pretty strong, actually. They used to always win, not win, but they used to always beat Denmark, the Franks, etc. In previous campaigns. Because they had the Slavic factions in this mod have mounted bodyguards, while the Vikings and others have dismounted bodyguards. I believe the Franks also have mounted bodyguards, but because of the mounted bodyguards, Vendland always won. I changed the bodyguard of Vendland into a dismounted bodyguard because I didn't like that they won all the time. Okay, so now they are nerfed. They have a dismounted bodyguard, but they are pretty strong. Okay, they are the main enemies of Denmark and the Frankish faction in mainland Europe and Polish areas here. They are pretty much a nation that predates the Poles. Okay, and then we have Krivichi, horse nomads here, the main enemy of the Gadarig Rus. We'll also fight the Balts. They are a horse-based Slavic tribe. They are East Slavs, union of Eastern Slavs, I believe. So they, if you place them, you will have horsemen and such, but also dismounted troops. And you will fight the Rus and the Balts mostly, and then the Eastern Slavs over here. Okay, and that's the factions of the game. Let's start the game. Take a look at the submod and what it brings to the table. Okay, so this is the Prussia faction, where the capital city is Medanea. Faction leader is King Brustdalens. British general is the same guy. He have one general and 10 regions controlled, 10 cities and 0 castles. There are no castles in this game because the era is the Viking Age. And it's before England and such started to build castles. Okay, so there are only villages, towns, and large towns, maybe cities. But I don't think so. And then, if there are cities, it's only the capitals. And it's unique for the Regnum Francorum submod and this submod then. In the original Wrath of the Norsemen, there were no cities with stone walls. I believe this submod might have added that. The Regnum Francorum submod, which this one is based on. Okay, so we have all areas are like villages at the start, except the capitals that are large towns, I believe. There are garrisons in each area. We do not have many buildings, so they need to build up everything from scratch. So you need to build up your villages, build everything in them, and then upgrade into a town and build stuff there, and then upgrade into a large town and build more stuff to get the best economy, the best troops, etc., the best agents, such as spies, diplomats, assassins, priests, and merchants. Okay, and in the beginning you do not have many troops. You don't have any troops in most of the areas. This is the capital, Medanea. You can only get merchants here, but you do have garrisons. You can see that Prussia has these guys, Kirviniuki troops. These men are semi-professional warriors. Okay, and we have some Vidivariers. They are Levy soldiers. We have the Butatows, which are the king's chosen elite, and they're this very veteran spearmen. So they have pretty good starting armies in the capital. Then in other areas, like this village here, Galinda, they have some ordinary troops like the Banderuki, which are raiders, travel across the seas to loot and pillage other settlements. So they are like Baltic raiders, or almost like the Vikings, but the Baltic version of them. Okay, we have the Skepnisi, free farmers who fight slight infantrymen. Okay, Strelniki, men without training to survive in close quarters. Okay, so basic stuff, throwing javelins and such. And we have these guys, the Dulfeni, which is fueled up fanatics. They are pretty good actually. Their version of berserkers. Okay, and we have a bunch of areas. Most areas are villages with the basic garrisons. We will fight other factions like the. This was Prussia, I believe. Okay, so the, but it's not Germans. I believe this faction is like an earlier area here. It's not made up of Germans, no. Because the German state of Prussia only arrived later in the medieval era. This is like a barbarian state that predates that state. So they are like local inhabitants of the area with the same name, probably. Okay, so they will fight the Koronians and the Krivichi horsemen, Eastern Slavic Union, and the Wendland Eastern Slavic people. Okay, next faction, we had the Morafylki faction, the Norse. They start with 10 areas. No, actually, they start with 5 areas. Regions controlled 5. They have one general. Faction leader is Konungr Finnjöder. And the same Finnvider, actually. And they have 5 cities, 0 castles, of course. Okay. They have mostly villages. They have a unique unit, the fishermen, like fishermen. Fishermen means pretty much fisherman. Okay, and then bogaman means bowman, pretty much. So basic bowman and fisherman. Then they have the brander. Don't really know what that means. And then they have herdmen. Herdmen, like leaders of the herd or something, herd. So they are good elite troops. Use this the bodyguard too for generals. They have the wrecker, they are medium javeliners. They have the vikingar or vikingar, also vikings in Swedish. So these are actual vikings. Raiders, sea raiders. They go on a Viking raid. Bogamen, bowmen, vigamen, they are like brawlers. Okay, bönder, they are like farmers actually. Bönder is very close to bonde in Swedish, which means farmer. Okay, and then we have fattvekis folk, or fattigt folk, which means poor people. So they are the poor people, and even worse than the bonder, which are farmers. Okay, and these guys are even better than the farmers. They are brawlers. They are a yoke unit with ale in one hand and axe in the other. Bogamen, they're basic bowmen. Vikings, they are medium unit. They are pretty good. Okay, so that's a village. Most areas are villages. You can check their capital. Here is the Mörsker Hufvudborg, or Hedeborg. This is their capital. It's a village too. You see, so their capital is a village. they had their better troops here, like the brand or an elite Viking unit. Okay. Then we have the East Frankish faction, the Frankish Empire. They have 7 regions controlled, 2 generals. Capital city is Anseberian. Faction leader is Emperor Karl the Great. Greatest general is the same guy. Their capital is a town, so they have a more evolved settlement as their capital. They can build more buildings. They also have more buildings at the start, including a small church. They have a bunch of troops too. We have the Sagittari Minores. So the Franks, they fought a lot like the Roman Empire. They had legions like the Roman Empire and had their troops set up like the Romans. They had conquered Rome, the Franks, and then they had adopted their ways of fighting wars. So the Frankish army is pretty much like the Roman army of early medieval Europe. Okay, so they have a focus on cavalry. They have cavalry, light cavalry here. They have bowmen. They have spearmen, scutari minores. I have to excuse my way of pronouncing these names. They have milites fidelis, which are heavier cavalry, and they have the Scarsua elite cavalry, and they have a bodyguard too. And then in their other areas, they have some Saxon areas, Frisian areas. Here we have where Spiri, light javeliners, Spiriliod actually, medium spearmen, Hersimon, medium archers, Freletmund, spearmen, light spearmen, and Spiriliod, medium spearmen. And they have some cavalry. Some of their areas are more Saxon than French. Conquered some Saxon areas. Okay, that's the Franks. We have this faction, it's pretty huge. Cursi, Curonians. They're mostly villages with the same units as the Prussian faction. Their capital. So let's see the faction. Capital city is Palanga. They have 13 regions, one general, 13 cities, 0 castles, yeah. Palanga is their capital. This is the largest faction yet, with 13 areas. They are pretty strong. Strongest Baltic faction in the game. Hold Vilnius here. Can't really find their capital. Yeah, they have the same units as the other Baltic faction. Here is their capital. It's a village. Here they have some better troops. The Sviri, veteran spearmen. The Sobinviri, which are youngest men of the tribe, fight as mobile skirmishers. They have the Peshatsi Dragohai, which are members of the King's Drushina. They are really good, okay. So, this faction is large, but still has only a village as their capital. We have the Rigalandi Norse faction. The capital is a village. They have some really good Nautgestir troops. Heavy infantry. They also have two units of Karar. Karlar, which is Karar on Swedish, in Swedish, which means men, pretty much. Karar, or Kar, just means man, pretty much a manly man. So it's not a military name, it's like the word you use for manly men. A real Kar, which means a real man, pretty much. Okay, and there's some Bönder, or farmers, some bogamen or bowmen, and some Nautgestir. I don't know what that means. It's a Norse name, not a Swedish, so I don't know what it means. But they are an elite unit. Okay, their capital city is Ögvaldr. Ögvaldrnes, I believe. Ögvaldrnes. Something. Okay, they have one general and 5 regions. Their king is Konungr. Okay. And we have Gotland, or in Swedish, Götaland. Gotland, in this mod. The Geats, or Götar. Their regions are 11, they have 11 regions. They have capital cities. Jönköping, or Jönköping, English, the leader is Konungr. Heraldar Konungr, by the way, means Konung or King. So that's King pretty much in English, Konung. Swedish word for king is Konung. And here they are named Konungr in Old Norse. So the only difference between the Swedish word and the Old Norse word is that they've added an R in the end. So Konungr Heraldr means King Heraldr. Okay, that's the leader. They have two generals and 11 cities at start. And by the way, we have a new spy here added to this mode. Female spy from the Warhammer Call of Warhammer mod, but edited to fit a real historical setting. Removed all the stuff that were fantastical, all the fantasy stuff, all the gear that was fantasy based, and made it more realistic. I wanted some females on the map too, even though we already had princesses, but more than that, I wanted some shield maidens. Okay, so Gotland, they have similar units to the other Norse, but this faction is a ranged faction. They have mostly basic and medium stuff, and lightly armored ranged troops like the Lidsmen here, which is medium javeliners, and Rekkar also medium javelin throwers. They have some unique troops too that are javelin based, and some unique bowmen, the Vedemen. They are like longbowmen, they are better than the Bogamen and the Langbogamen. Langbogamen means longbowmen, and these are better than those. So this Norse faction is actually mostly focused on ranged units, but has weaker infantry than the others. They are a weaker faction. It has, still has 11 regions at the start. They are in between others. They have the Svitjod faction here, and the Vestfold faction, and they have the Danish faction. In history they would be absorbed into Svitjod, the Swedish faction, but for that maybe they had some relation with the Danes. In the game, I believe they are not allied to anyone, but they are at war with the Franks. I believe all the Norse are at war with the Franks. Franks are at war with every barbarian faction except the Sami and the Finns, because they are so far away. They wouldn't probably know about each other. We have Vestfold, or they knew about each other, but they never actually had an interaction. Okay, Vestfold. They are at war with Vestfold, neighbor, and with Svitjod, and with independent factions. They are not at war with Denmark, because it was written in their description that they might actually form an alliance against the Swedes, but in the long run, Denmark might not want just an alliance, so they can expect war with Denmark, or Denmark, in this mod, in the long run. Okay, let's end the turn. So, Vestfold, as we can see, is a huge Norse faction, Norwegian Norse faction. It's the second strongest faction in the game, I believe. Yeah, they are the second strongest faction in the game. They have 16 regions at start. And the capital city is Tunsberg. Their leader, faction leader, is Konungr Halfdan, or King Halfdan. They have one general, 16 cities, here are castles. And they are the faction that will unite Norway. So, Vestfold. They have a princess here. Unique model for this mod. Still looks vanilla, but more Nordic. Norse style there. The new models with unique textures on the shields. This is the soldier model. For the Vestfold faction, I believe others have different armor and different shield textures. The generals have the same armor. I might change that in a later update. But they have different shield textures. So this is the Vestfold one. All of them use the same armor currently. There are three variations we could use. So I will probably add different ones for them later, and different capes too, and different pants. There are three variations of capes, three variations of armor, and three variations of pants that we can divide between the Norse, the Swedes, and the Danes. But for now, they use the same cape, the same pants, and the same armor. but different shield textures to differentiate between the factions. The soldiers have different armors too, and there were more than three different armors for the soldiers. They had like seven different, I believe. Yeah, and there were eight factions, I believe. We have three Swedish factions, one Danish faction, and four Norse. So there are eight Norse factions, and plus the Rush one. And the Swedes and the Rus share models, and yeah, there were seven different armor variations. So I believe the Swedes and Westfold share the same armor, but have different shield texture. Yeah. Okay, so this is the second strongest faction in the game. They are at war with many factions. They are at war with other Norse factions. They are at war with Frankish faction. They're at war with Gotland, the independent factions, the rebels, and with Denmark too, and Jutland. Okay, so they are at war with every Norse faction. Yeah, they are not at war with Svitjod. They could be allied with Svitjod. Yeah, I believe Lagertha was from a Norse faction, probably Westfold, so they should have probably good relations with Svitjod. Yeah, okay. Then we have the Sami faction. They are mixed between Sami and Finns, as I said. They have a lot of areas here up in the north. They are in between the Swedish faction and the Finnish faction, and Helgoland and Norse faction. They have 10 areas. So not too few, but not too many. We have two generals. So their capital city is Kalix, and the faction leader is King Kalerio, or Kalervo, actually, Kalervo. Okay, they have no allies. They are at war with the Ham and Finnish faction. So the two Finnish factions are at war with each other, meaning you have an enemy on this border. And then they are at war with Svitjod, this faction. Real history, of course, Svitjod or Sweden. I believe later when they became Sweden, they would conquer these areas. Least these areas, then the Norse would take these areas, and then these areas would also belong to Sweden. I believe Sweden would conquer all of Finland. So anyway, so Sweden would take everything here, and the Norse would take a little bit up here. Maybe later the Russians would take this area. Okay, but in this game the Sami and the Finns are one faction, and we have a different Finnish faction here. In the main mod, we have a bunch of rebel areas all over the map representing unconquered tribes. So we have like a bunch of playable factions with one or two areas at the start, and then the rest of the map, another 99 regions. We have the maximum number of regions of a medieval Total War mod, which is 199. Most of the map would be rebel controlled, but in this submod, Factions United, I released at first in on Monday a few days ago, 5 days ago. In this mod, all the factions start with all their territory that they had historically at one point, and the rebels are extinct. There are no rebel territories anymore, and that means that instead of the Sami Finns starting with two areas, and the Finns down here, the Hami, starting with two areas, they start with the entire areas. We have two giant Finnish factions, and the difference between them is that the Finns down here only have Finnish units, but they can hire Sami mercenaries up here. Anyone can do that, that have generals in this area, while the Sami Finnish faction, they are like the Hami in that their main troops are Finnish, like the Hami faction, but they start in the areas of the Sami, so they have easier access to the Sami. That's why I count them as the Sami faction, and this faction as the Finnish faction. But both are Finnish, and the Sami, they are mercenaries for anyone who have generals in these areas. Okay, the music would differ too. I would use the Finnish music for Hame and the areas here, and the Sami music for the Kvenland faction and their areas. Okay, so they will fight the Hami faction and the Svitjod faction, but they are not at war with Helgoland, the Norse faction here. Which means they could be allied. Okay. Then we click next turn. We are now controlling Gardarike Ras or Gardarike Ras. Their capital city is Novgorod. Faction leader is Veliki Knyaz Igor. Veliki Knyaz Igor. Blue Knyaz means king. And Veliki, I am not sure, but if I would guess, I would say Varenjan King Igor. Varenjan King Igor, probably. Okay, so he's the leader. Regions controlled, 5. Generals, 1. These are the Rus, pretty much mixed between Eastern Slavs and Norse. They are led by Norse and have some Norse units, but most of their army is Eastern Slavic. I believe the Slavs invited a Norse hero to come and rule them, and yeah, that's why they have a mix between Norse and Slavic troops. Their capital, Novgorod, is a village, but they have some good troops, they have some bad troops too. They have the Fatuikis folk, the worst Norse unit of everyone, poor people, pretty much. They have Rekkar, they are pretty good, medium Norse javelin throwers, a really good cavalry unit, Rus horsemen, medium unit or heavy. They have the Vityasi, which are like heavy survivors and veterans of past battles. They are really good, actually. Okay, they have some basic areas, villages, with the same type of garrisons in them. We have the Borsia, basic Slavic warriors. We have the Lusniki, which are like their bowmen, Slavic bowmen. We have Bonder, the Norse like farmers. We have the Vodja. Axe was a favorite weapon among the tribal warriors. Cheap but devastating, Slavs made good use of mystic axes, specialized battle axes. Okay, so these are like tribal warriors. The Vodja, they throw javeliners and fight with spears, and we have some Rekkar, medium Norse javelin throwers too. It's a faction that is a mix between the Norse and the Eastern Slavs, with strat models shared with the Svitjod-faction, the Swedish faction. Okay, then we have Helgoland. They have a pretty vast territory, a long stretch of land. It will take a long time to move from one area to the other if you do not use ships. So they are dependent on ships for their troop movement. Their capital is Narvik, and the faction leader is Konungr Haraldr, or King Haraldr. They have an heir, Erfinger Heidanger. They hold 14 areas. They are probably the third strongest faction in the game. 2 generals. Diplomacy, they are toward the Frankish Empire, the independent factions, the rebels, and with Westfold. They are the main rival of Westfold, of course, the second strongest Norse faction. Third strongest Viking faction. Okay, and their areas very widespread. Most of them are villages, of course. They have similar units to others. Poor people, farmers, brawlers, ale hall brawlers. They have Vikings and bowmen. Okay, village. Narvik is a village too. Do they have any elite troops anywhere? Yeah, they have some good troops here. The Huskarlar, or Huskarl. So, Karl just means a real man, and Huskarl means similar. You see, Hus in Swedish, or Hus, means house, and Karl means a real man. So, Huskarl just means house Karl, which means house man. So, they are just housemen. And the difference between them and the men, or Karls, are that they are heavily armored, unlike the others, and have a helmet, unlike the others. They are like the elite version. The Karlar are medium, and the Huskarlar are heavy. So, men and housemen, pretty much. And the housemen have armor, and the men do not have armor. They have medium armor. Okay, then we have a unique unit here. The Helager Leidangsfolk, which is a unique unit for this faction. local land. Javelin throwing spear unit, I believe. What else do they have? They have some more of the Huskarlar. Okay, so, not much else. Then we have the Hammer faction, the second Finnish faction in the game. The one that starts outside of the Sami areas. They have the same units as Kvenland. With the focus on the Finnish ones, they can also hire Finnish units as mercenaries. So we have units like the Orhout. These men are the fierce and brave shock troops. Okay. Nuru Kaiset. Youngest man of the tribe. Okay. Fight as noble skirmishers. Aikahishred. Mobile and tactical and flexible infantry unit. They are the backbone of the armies of Hammett. These are the basic troops. Like the farmers. K-Heis-Maihed troops. They are, in times of emergency, the poorer and the older men of the tribe and may be leave it to fight. So these are the poorer and older men, okay. And they're, let's check the faction, they have 13 areas. Same as the Kersey in numbers. The capital city is Venaya. And the faction leader is Kunerikas Ulias, probably King Ulias. The capital is a village. A lot of troops there, but mostly basic troops like the Aikaishet and the Nuorukaishet troops. You also have some Yosmiehet troops. I have a very difficult time saying Finnish names or words. Sebastian Archers, so that's their archers or bowmen. Okay, and they are at war with the independent factions, the Swedish faction and the Kvenland faction. They only have a border with the Kvenland faction, so that's their main enemy. They have a border with the Gardarik Ras too, but they are not at war with them. Okay, so that's the Finns. They have 13 areas. This entire area, pretty much all Finland. Okay. Then we have Jutland. They only have one area. Visbyr, their capital, which is a village. Gutnisker Huvudborg, or Hedborg. Okay, their leader is Konungr Ovar, or King Ovar. Avar, probably in English, but Ovar in Swedish. Okay, regions controlled one, generals one. They are at war with a lot of people because they used to raid other nations or tribes. Okay, so they are at war with independent factions, the rebels. They are at war with Svitjod, of course. They are at war with Denmark, their main enemy. They are at war with Westfold, French Empire, and Prussia. They used to raid Prussia, that's why. Okay. And unlike the others, they did not get any new areas in the submod Factions United. So they have one area, they have a fleet. They are one of few factions with a huge fleet. Other factions with a huge fleet would be Svitjod, Swedish faction, Denmark, the Danes, and Westfold. They have a huge fleet. Also, I believe Moira Fylke and Rigaland, they have smaller fleets too. So all the Norse have fleets. And don't know if the others have any fleets. Maybe the Prussians have that, I don't know. But the Gutnisker fleet, the Gutish fleet, they are one of the bigger fleets actually, because they need a fleet to raid others for their economy and to protect themselves. Okay, so they start with a village. They can get poor people, Fatwekis folk, and merchants, and Karfi, the basic Viking ship. Their troops, they have a garrison, they have two units of bogamen or bowmen, they have one unit of leadsmen, the better medium javeliners, they have two units of vikingar or vikings, one unit of rekkar javelinmen, also medium but worse than the leadsmen. I fixed the leadsmen in this update, by the way. They are no longer glitched when in melee. They look good in battle. Jomsvikingar, they are a unique mercenary Viking unit that you can recruit in an area down here, I believe. Maybe in other areas too. They are still medium javelin throwers, but they are better in melee than the others. And use axes in melee, unlike the others that use spears, I believe. And they are like an elite unit. Mercenary elite unit, they have a unique unit of Farmadur, Gutnish unique troops. The only really unique unit for Gutland. So their army is pretty good, you just need to spend some time and build it up before you can start raiding. If you start from scratch, they will get basic stuff like the poor people, farmers, bowmen and such. It will take a while until you get enough population size in order to upgrade the village into a town. When you get a town, you can start getting better troops. And when you get a large city, I believe you can get every troop. You need a, not large city, but large town. When you get a large town, only then can you get the best troops. Because only the large town can build the best buildings and such, I believe. Okay, so Gutland is the faction you want to play if you want to play a Norse faction and have a real challenge, because they are the weakest faction in the game due to only having one area. You will raid others and take their areas and such. Okay. So Gutland. Then we have Denmark. Then the Kingdom of Denmark, or Danmark in this game, also Danmark in Swedish. In Old Norse they were named Danmark. Okay, so Danmark, the strongest faction in the game, they have 19 area regions at the start. Regions control 19. They have the largest territory. You can see that Denmark has one more area here than in modern day Denmark. And then they have a lot of areas in modern day Sweden. They have the area of Skåne, which is this area. They hold a bunch of areas here, including this area. Areas that Sweden would later conquer from Denmark. So Denmark is stronger during the Viking Age than they were later. They are bigger than they are today, while Sweden is divided into three different tribes, and Norway is divided into four different tribes. While Denmark is united and is actually larger in the Viking Age than they are in modern day Denmark. I believe Germany has taken an area here, and Sweden has taken all the areas in Sweden. So they no longer have an area on the mainland here. Okay. But in this game they hold a vaster territory than in modern day, and they are the largest faction. The capital city is Roarskelda. Faction leader is Konungr Siegfrieder, or King Siegfrieder. Means Siegfried in I believe in English, Siegfried, and King Siegfried, and in Swedish that would be Siegfried. Okay, he's the greatest general. They have one general, 19 areas. Their economy is pretty big, 280,000. They needed a good economy because they have a lot of garrisons in all their areas. They will fight, they have the Obotrite Western Slavs here, a weak faction, then they have the Vendland Western Slavs, one of their main enemies in the mainland, and then they have the French. So their main enemy here will be the French and Vendland, and then they have the smaller enemy of the Obotrites that will easily conquer. Okay, and then in Scandinavia they have the Geats, Gotland, which could be an ally against the Swedes. That could also be an enemy. Okay, and then they have Vestfold above up here, another enemy. We are a naval rival to the Danes, second strongest faction. Then they have Gutland here, an enemy they might want to conquer. Okay, so Denmark is the strongest and most powerful Norse faction. Okay, their troops at the start similar to others, but in Skåne they have some unique Skånskir Leidangsfolk javelin throwers, light javelin throwers that are unique for this area of Skåne. Mercenaries in this area. Okay, for anyone who is in this area with a general. Okay, then they have some basic farmers, more of the Skånskir Leidangsfolk, and they have Karar. Karlar. Yeah. And then they have some Vigaman and Rekkar. Same units as the other Norse. Should have some unique elite troops too, of course. Not sure if they started with any of them. They have an army here with a leader. He has a unit of Digger Axemen, their elite unit, unique for Denmark or Denmark. So they are like a heavy Huskarl unit, but unique to Denmark, better than the Huskarls. They have some wreckguards, farmers, yeah, bowmen. And their capital is a village. So yeah, I probably forgot to turn the capital back into a village for some fact. I believe the Swedish capital is a large town or town. We'll probably update the game with the music change and change every capital back to a village, because in this mod it's supposed to start with just villages to start. The only exception is the Frank faction. They will start with a town. Everyone else would start with a village actually, and then you build it up from scratch. But I believe that I fucked up. Let's see here. You can see the map. It's vast. All the factions have vast territories. No rebel areas anymore in this submod. Swedes will check them later, but I believe that their capital. Maybe I have turned them back into a village. Yeah, good. Everyone but the Franks start with a village. Okay. This was Denmark. Now we're on Svitjod, the Swedish faction. They have a fleet too. Two fleets separated here. We can merge them. They have four ships. They have the Karfi and the Snekja. Snekja means pretty much snake. And Karfi, I don't really know. Okay, so in their capital of Sigtunir, so Sweden's capital used to be Sigtuna, which is Sigtunir in Old Norse. Stockholm didn't exist until later, and Old Uppsala, which is like a different area than modern day Uppsala. There is a city in Sweden known as Uppsala, but there were another one named today as Old Uppsala on a different location in Sweden, where the Vikings or Norse used to go and pray and such. So it's not the same city, they have the same name, but the Uppsala of this mod is not the same Uppsala as in modern day Sweden. It's on in a different location. The only difference, the only similarity is that they shared a name. They built a new city and gave it the same name. Okay, so Sigtuna or Sigtunir is their capital. Yes. They have some troops, Vikingar. Some troops here too. The Leedsmen. The Bonder, the Karar, the Vigaman, nothing special. They have some unique stuff in their capital. They have Konungr Ragnar, which is Ragnar Lothbrok actually. So this guy is Ragnar Lothbrok. He's the Svea Jarl, leader of Svealand, the Jarl of Svealand. Faction leader. He started as Crown Prince of Svitjod and later became King of all of Denmark, but in this game you can only get Denmark by conquering Denmark. You can never get their unique troops, as that feature isn't implemented. There is no regional recruitment. They might add that for the elite units when they conquer all of their areas. But anyway, yeah, this mod could use a lot of new features and events and such. But anyway, they have berserkers from the start. So the Swedish faction, unlike the others, have berserkers at the start. They do not have the berserk attribute, because if I want to use that without crashing in battle, then I need the M2DV EUP tool or Medieval Tutor or Engine Aura Project tool that they had previously implemented for the main mod, but didn't want to be dependent on that. So I removed it, and that's why I removed the berserk attribute. I will probably add it if I'm gonna play the mod myself, because the berserk attribute is nice. It makes the berserkers and the Ulfenars go berserk in battle, and then they get a special trait which make the Sess heroic, so they are really really good and powerful in battle with the berserk attribute. But unfortunately it requires the tool, because in Rome Total War the berserkers actually worked fine, but in Medieval 2 the attribute followed from Rome Total War into Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms, but whenever you used the attribute for a unit, it would crash in battle as soon as the unit in question reached the enemy, so it didn't work on Medieval 2. They didn't properly implement animations for the Berserk attribute. It would crash because it missed out animations, it lacked animations unique for that attribute. But the tool re-implemented the animation, even though it looks worse than in Rome Total War, but it was still re-implemented. So by using that tool you can use the Berserk attribute without crashing in battle. So the Berserk attribute was in Medieval 2, but the animation for it wasn't, so that's why it crashed. Okay, and with the tool you could play it because the animation was re-implemented. However, not in the best way possible. It doesn't look nearly as cool as in Rome Total War. It actually looks a little bit glitched, but at least it works and the unit will become way more powerful. But you need a two-handed axe unit with that animation, otherwise it looks worse. It looks bad. I believe the Berserkers in this and the Ulfednars, which are like Berserkers, or Berserkers with wolf skin instead of deer skin. I believe Berserkers in Old Norse means Berserkers in English, which means Berserkers in Swedish, which means bear skins in a proper translation into English. So Berserk here means pretty much bear skin, and Ulfhednar, that's pretty much a word for wolf heaten, pretty much. It means wolf heaten. So, and the difference is that the Ulfhednar has wolf skins and the Berserkers have bear skins, but they are similar units. I believe in the Norse area where they had Ulfhednars, there were no bears, that's why they used wolves. Probably, or they were rare. Anyway, they serve the same purpose. They are druids and yeah, religious. Okay, so we have Berserker with Svitjod, the only faction that starts with them, but others can still get them. I believe all the Norse factions can get Berserkers. I'm not sure if the Ras can get them, but I think so. But you need to upgrade the settlement into probably a large town or town, but at least a large town, and then you need a specific building. In this mod, I believe you need certain buildings in order to build other buildings, and you need certain buildings to build certain troops. That's why it will be pretty late game before you get the elite troops, if you don't count the elite troops you start with. Also, we have Lagertha in this mod, in this sub-mod. She's using a portrait from the show, which is a little bit out of place, but I used it from the other sub-mod for Last Kingdom. Move her out, she has a Swedish banner on shield texture. It's a unique model based on the Call of Warhammer Shield Maidens, but edited to fit the historical setting. She looks the same in battle, but slightly worse because the shield looked a little bit worse there. Okay, but this is Lagertha, she has a model in battle too. So both Ragnar Lothbrok and Lagertha the Shield Maiden. But Ragnar is, I believe, married to Aslaug in this mod. Yeah. Okay. Age 24. Okay. They're pretty young here. Lagertha is the only one with a unique model. Okay, so this is Svitjod. They have 16 areas, the same number as Westfold, I believe. Then I believe this faction is stronger than Helgoland, so this is the third strongest faction in the game. Westfold the second strongest, and Denmark the strongest. Then Helgoland is probably the fourth strongest, yeah. Okay. Ragnar Lothbrok is their leader. Lagert is their heir, or Erfinger. Arvinge, Swedish. Okay, let's click end turn. Then we are in control of the Obotrites, another Eastern Slavic faction. Their leader is Kning Bersen, or King Versen. Their capital city is Stargard. Or Strandgård in Swedish. Okay. They have some Slavic troops, same as the other Slavs. They have the Borgia, the Bodje, the Svenske Draugheim. Pretty good cavalry unit. They used to be the bodyguard of the Wismenslavs, but they changed them to an ordinary unit. Didn't want them to have cavalry as a bodyguard because they would always win against Denmark and such in the end. And in this Viking Age mod, I believe the Vikings should be the strongest, not the Slavs. That's why I changed it. I didn't like that Vendland always won. Even in one campaign, I saw that the Ubertrades won because they had the cavalry bodyguard, heavy cavalry. And that's very OP against factions that do not have cavalry as bodyguards. Okay, they. For some reason they even won against the Franks, despite the Frankish cavalry being better. Probably because their economy was better than the Franks. Okay, so this is a Slavic faction too. But they only have three areas. So they are weak and are in between the other factions. And then we have Vendland, the like other Western Slavic faction. They are like Poland before Poland, pretty much. They have similar units as the others, but they have seven regions. Used to be the strongest faction in the game, in the late game, thanks to their mounted bodyguard. But now they do not have a mounted bodyguard, so... the Balts still have mounted bodyguards and the Franks, but the Balts are so far away from the Norse that it didn't matter. Whenever they reach each other, the Danes have by then conquered these areas and then face off here. And it doesn't matter if the Balt take these areas from Denmark. They should probably only expand here historically. So it didn't matter much. They didn't want Vendland to conquer everything here. Okay. So there are a few factions with mounted bodyguards, but most factions have these mounted bodyguards. Okay. Then we have the Krivichi faction, the Eastern Slavic Union. They have mostly horsemen. They have a lot of infantry too, same infantry as the other Slavs. They have the Nemsi, foreigners or Norse mercenaries. They have the Konika, light Slavic cavalry armed with javelins and axes. Same type of cavalry unit as the Norse, but the unique one for this faction. I believe they share it with the other Slavic factions too. They are used more common in this faction. They have a lot of cavalry units that are unique for them. They have the Krivichi Nobles, a unique cavalry unit. And the Svenske Draugheim. Okay, so they have some unique troops. Cavalry troops that the other Slavic factions don't have. So unlike the other Slavs, this faction has like two more cavalry units. At least one more. They have eight regions. The capital city is Plock. And the leader is King Radoslav or King Radoslav. Okay. They are pretty good. They're pretty strong because of their cavalry. They have more cavalry than the others. That's why they are pretty strong. Okay. A candidate for Dauphin. We don't care about that. We are back at controlling Prussia. Of course, this mod is using custom settlements as well. And custom music is available. Okay, so the sub-mod, unlike the main mod, lets you start with every territory of each faction. In the main mod, you would start with only two areas in each for each faction and then conquer a lot of areas from the rebels before you reach the other factions. In this sub-mod, Factions United, or Wrath of the Norsemen, the Baltic, Factions United, you start with all their territory and can start fighting the others immediately. Okay. Okay, about battles. Yeah, we could exit. Do a quick battle, hopefully it will work. Main change of the sub-mod was that they added territory at the start for each faction and increased the economy for each faction to be able to handle the new regions with all their garrisons, and added all the garrisons of each region, you know, the old rebel garrisons, to each faction, so they are controllable now instead. Ok, Okay, so this is a battle. We are in control of Svitjod, the Swedish Norse faction. We have a few units. We used a quick battle, so that's why they do not have more than 10,000 at start to recruit an army. So it's not a full-sized army. You can have 20 units in a full-sized army in this game and in a mod. But instead you have like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 units here. So we have a unit of Longbowmen. The best bowman unit for most of the Norse faction do not have a better bow unit than this one. I believe the Vedermen, unique bow unit for Gotland, is better, but they are also available to the others if you are in the right area of Gotland. Okay, we have the Bunder or Farmers, their basic spearman unit. Spearmen were the most common units of the Norse. Their basic people, troops. Then they have the Jomsvikingar, which is like elite Viking soldiers throwing javelins and then charging with axes and swords. We have more of the Bunder or Farmers. We have a cavalry unit, the Svenska Riddarar, also known as Swedish Riddare. Svenska Riddare or Swedish Knights. So these are Riddarar is a word for knight in Old Norse. Swedish word is riddare, and the Old Norse word is riddarar. So it means knight, and svenskir just means Swedish or svensk. So svenskir riddarar means Swedish knight. The Swedish knights are the only heavy cavalry unit of the game in use by a Norse faction. So the Swedes were first at using heavy cavalry. The other Norse factions have access to light javeliners, mounted javeliners, but they do not have access to heavy cavalry. I believe if they are in the Slavic areas, they can probably get mercenary Konica troops, which are also light or medium javelin throwing cavalry, but I don't know if they can get any of the heavy cavalry from the Slavs. I don't know if they were mercenaries. So this might be the only heavy cavalry in use by a Norse faction. So if you want heavy cavalry, you need to play as the Swedish faction, the Svitjod faction. They have the best cavalry, but they are the unit is a late game unit. You won't get it until very, very late game. And they are obviously elite. All the Norse have mounted javeliners, but only Svitjod has the heavy cavalry knights. Okay, so then we didn't have any more. We have the Rekkar javelin throwing. No, the Lidsmen. They used to be bugged in Melee, now they are not anymore. And we have the General's Bodyguard, the Herdmen. Viking unit. Heavy chainmail armor and good helmets. Better shields and such. See here, we will group everyone. We will place everyone in shield wall formation. If we can. The Riddar unit do not have any formations. Even the farmers can use shield wall. It's the Viking Age. Everyone can use shield wall that has a shield. If the Langbogamen, they can use fire arrow. Of course, the General's Bodyguard can't use the shield wall because they need that button for the horn. Okay, but if you have more than one General's Bodyguard in the army, then they can use shield wall. Okay, let's start the game, the battle I mean. Let's check the enemy. So we have Gutland here. Okay, another Norse faction. They have their unique javelin thrower unit. Unique for this faction, the Farmadur. But you can still recruit it as mercenary troops if you are in Gutland, I believe. Maybe some other areas too. Near Gutland, I believe. But it's a Gutnish unique unit, the only unique one of their faction. The javelin throwing melee unit, and they have some karar or karls, medium two-handed axe unit with shields on the back. They have the huskarlar or huskarl unit, the heavy version, the same unit, housecarls. They have the lidsmen, so they have that unit too. And they have some rekkar. They are slightly worse, but they are also they might be better. The Rekkar are javelin throwers, melee javelin throwers with axes in melee, I believe, axes and swords. And the Lids, when they have spears in melee, but they are also medium javelin throwers. Both are javelin throwers, but they have different melee weapons. And I believe the Rekkar might be better because they have axes and maybe swords, but I think axes at least, while the Lidsmen have spears. They have a bodyguard, of course. So, the difference between the Carls and the Huskarls are the armor, and the Farmadur, they are unique units, they are elite, even if they do not have heavy armor. Okay, let's just let the AI fight this battle. There will be vanilla music. Zoom in on the minimap. Balance of forces is evenly matched. Both armies were automated. They're using the quick battle. I believe we'll win. We have heavy cavalry. They do not have any cavalry, as far as I know. And even if they had gotten the mounted javeliners, they would still have sucked against the Swedish riddarar troops, Svenska riddarar in melee. The only good melee cavalry in the game, used by the Norse. I believe the Slavs have some good cavalry in the Balts too. I believe the bodyguard of the Balts and one of the elite units of the Slavs, and especially that Krivichi unit which has Hetzla, the Krivichi unit. The Krivichi faction had like one mounted javeliner unit, so similar like the Norse, and then all the Norse have that too, and then they had two units of heavy cavalry, so they have even more cavalry than this faction. Yeah, this is... they wasted their cavalry against spearmen, that wasn't smart. And it's not certain they will be in. They have lost their cavalry already. Cavalry advantage. AI decided to suicide against spearmen. With the cavalry. This battle quickly became a mess. Zoom in on the minimap, we can see everything close on the map. The green versus the red. The red is the enemy and the green is our troops. Okay, so we killed 35%, they have killed 24%. We are leading. This mod, of course, has a lot of infantry battles. It's mostly infantry in this mod fighting each other. Models are pretty good. It's a Viking based mod, set in the Viking Age, starting in the year of 785. I mean, the Viking Age started in the year of 793 in England, when Lindisfarne was raided by Norsemen. And this starts a bit before that. Right. Yeah, there are unique custom music. The Norsemen have different music. I believe the Danes have unique versions of the music. I believe the Danes have unique songs. The Swedes, Gutes, and the Gutes. I believe the Geats and the Gutes. No, I was wrong. The Danes and the Swedes share music in this game. And the Gutes and the Geats share music, and then the four Norse factions share music, and then the Slavs share music with each other, and then the Balts share music, and the Finns have unique music, and the Sami Finns have different music maybe, or they share with the Finns, and then the French have unique music. And if you download the mod currently, you will have the custom music already implemented, ready to go. If you want the vanilla music, you need to download a specific package and install it by following the instructions. In the future, I might actually make the vanilla music the pre-installed music, and then the custom music will be like an optional package within the mod. But for now, you get it when you download the mod. Yeah. I just didn't want it in this video. despite the music being great, of course, because I was worried that YouTube, would just censor the video, making it obsolete. You know, I make the video so you can get information about the mod and the changes and such, and if they block it, it would ruin the point of making the video in the first place. That's why I disabled that music. Okay. The Langboga man has already fled. Unit routes. Okay. This mod also has unique Viking or Norseman UI, etc. 73% enemies killed, 45% allies killed. We are leading. The Gutnish are being defeated. Forgot to place them in AI control, that's why the battle became a mess, I see. I was surprised it looked like a mess, it usually won't. They had forgotten to place them in AI control, that's very stupid. I had too much other stuff that I thought about in my head, so I just ordered them to charge without first placing them under AI control. That just meant that the troops would charge forward and attack the same unit and become a mess. Still managed to somehow lead in the battle. Killed 78%, they killed 48%, so we are leading, we will probably win the battle. Despite the cavalry doing very poorly in the beginning of the battle. Of course the player can use cavalry very smartly, in a very smart way, to have a clear advantage with heavy cavalry. You can move them back and forth and attack the troops in such smart ways. Where you kill a lot of their infantry each time you attack, but the AI, sometimes they are smart and sometimes they are idiots. When they're idiots they attack the spearmen with the cavalry, and when they're smart they move them back and forth and attack the right infantry troops, swordsmen and such. Okay. Usually when they are led by generals in the campaign that have good stats, they are doing better. Are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory. So I want to start a campaign in this sub-mode, but I first want to re-implement the Berserk attribute, because I prefer using Berserkers when they have Berserk attribute on. So I will probably re-implement that before starting any campaign in this game. I will still use this music, so most of the music will be the same, unfortunately, in the game. I believe when you use vanilla music, it will have the same music for most factions, even between cultures.
The enemy general is dead! We have sent the idiot to hell!
So the Norse, the French, the Slavs, the Balts, and the Finns might have the same music. When you use the vanilla music, the custom music, they have different per culture. That's nice. And the Norse even have different based on who they are. Norse, Danes, or Swede. Okay, when we killed 92%, they killed 56%.
Praise the Almighty.
Battle is over.
Okay.
Monday, 5 days ago. It's Saturday today. Yeah, the month is April 2022 is the year. Alright, thank you for watching. The mod can be downloaded on modabay.com right now, which I highly recommend. Okay, so bye.